Hello, I'd like to make today a cake Psycho Delia. And what we need for this recipe, we need two glass bowls, which is 2 liters each, or you can use 7 cup pudding steamers as well. And we need 340 gram butter cake mixes, which is we mix according to instructions on back of a packet, all three together. Then what we do is generously spray your glass bowls with a cooking spray, divide your three together prepared cakes among 2 glass bowls and bake for about 50 minutes. Or until skewer inserted in the center comes out clean. Let cakes, once they bake, sit in the bowls for about 10 minutes before place in a wire rack to completely cool down. Once they completely cool down, what we have to do is we're using a serrated knife to level both cakes so they are completely flat. Next step is to use a cake board, and also if you like you can use a basic vanilla frosting or simply use any jam of your choice. I'm using plum jam because I will just assemble using plum jam today. So we just place a small amount just in the middle. Place a first cake in and apply jam to join our cakes together. Once applied jam, what we do is we place the second cake on top. More flatter you make them, better they actually look, because they joined really perfectly well. So once we've done this, join them nicely and perfectly, make sure edges is comes together. And what we do is next, we're using jam again. If you're using the other jam, just make sure you actually sieve to make sure no any kind of the particles in it. So we simply brush on top, or apply with knife if you like it. Once finished applying jam or frosting, what we do is we need to create a flesh color fondant. What we need for that, if you're able to just purchase one, just simply purchase it, makes easy. If not, use a plain white fondant and add small amount of red gel food coloring. Knead it together until achieve beautiful pinkish type of appearance. So what we do is once we've done that, basically we need sprinkle our working surface with powdered icing sugar, and we roll out into round shape larger than our cake, and we simply transfer on top. Once it roll out, what we do is just make sure it doesn't stick, put plenty of icing, powdered icing sugar, and we simply transfer on top. Do not roll fondant too thinly to make sure it's nice and thick. Cut some sections out and join them together. Do not worry if it's not perfectly on the sides, it will cover by hair. Do not throw leftovers because we will re-roll and make eyebrows and a mouth. So just place under, smooth any imperfections to make it beautiful head, and remove any extra.
we achieve nice head.
Next is use the licorice roll, or if you have it, a licorice roll as well. So just a color from the cut it from licorice roll basically a strip to make sure enough to go around neck. Place it on a flat surface. If you're using a licorice rope, you don't have to do that. You just place strut around. So, and we cut about 2 tiny sections of the licorice rope. Just a 2 tiny sections. So we just keep going like that and trim it away. And what we do is, we just simply place and wrap around neck, just like this. Join together and remove excess if it's need to do so. So that's for collar. Next step is to fit hair around the line. So we're using the bright crawlers. They come in shapes like this. And as well, this is what I was only able to find it. If you best of all to use the longer snakes, like if you're able to find it like a snakes alive, or just simply long snakes, it just makes it easier to insert them because they cover head much faster. But if you have just a short ones, that's okay as well. We need about 4 packets of those to cover entire head, and we're using toothpicks to insert and into cake and into snake. If you use the full long snakes, use the full toothpicks with 2 pointed ends. Or if you use, just like I use, the smaller snakes, best of all to break the toothpicks on half. It just makes it easier a little bit to work with. And simply insert it in and insert into the snake and insert into the head to represent hair. So what we do, we just make like this to cover entire head. So what we do is, just one more time, take your snake, place pointed end in, just like this, and simply insert it into cake. So once we cover head, as you can see, all hair is done. So we do top and the sides as well. Next step is to make some eyebrows, mouth, and all the other parts as well. But take small amount, just 1 teaspoon of reserved fondant, and add few drops of the warm water and mix together to create a paste. We need this paste to use to attach various parts, silver pearls, and any parts we need to attach, we just simply use this paste. So once you mix it with water, set aside. Next step is use your reserved fondant. And what we do, just place a little bit of powdered icing sugar up here. We roll 2 sausages equal size, shape them into eyebrows with slightly pointed end, and slightly just squash it in to make it more flat, to make more like an eyebrow shape. That for the eyebrows. As you can see, they will go here. Next step is roll an oval of remaining reserved pink fondant, which is left over, and we use one of those large lolly teeth. So what we do, we just simply snip it, the part of lolly teeth right here, because that's slightly too much for us, the gum part, to make it just a teeth. And we stride them up, just like we've done with this one. Choose, of course, best type of teeth. And once our oval is done, what we do is we just simply roll over the top, just like this, and slightly roll over the bottom part, roll over in to make it lips. Join together as the lips and just simply shape it. Check it out how teeth will fit as well. And what we do is next we just simply attach teeth just right under the lip and cover with remaining fondant the gum part. Once it's done, place on top of baking paper before we apply on cake. So next step is add all the decorations. For the collar, we add some silver pearl, so silver cachons. Attach eyebrows with the paste done it before. Just apply a small amount and simply attach. All the parts need to be attached. Use this paste. For the eyes, we use brown Smarties, or simply use brown M&Ms. And for pupils, we use mini red M&Ms, just like this, brown for the eyes. So attach those. Paste a little bit stronger, and then we attach. Now, then what we do is we just attach the eyebrows. We use green dupes, which is we just simply get rid of one sugary side and slice it half. So we get something like this. And we cut triangles from it to make it eyelashes. Repeat with the second eye. I find it difficult to stick mini M&Ms, so I just simply use red writing icing, and what we do is we just create pupils. So what we do is next we attach a little nose. I saw from the dupes, so we add our mixture and we just attach. What we do is next we use red gel food coloring. Place a small amount and add a tiny bit of water. So use a small brush, just mix it together with water. You can use with vodka as well, dry will be faster, and simply apply for the lips to create just lips. Then take a toothpick, just dip into this gel water, which just creates like a red coloring, and simply go over. So once we've done that, use a black writing icing, fit it with a tip number 203. And we create some decorations on the top of eyebrow. Use your toothpick to adjust any imperfections and attach a blue pearl on top. Then what you do is just use a small amount of the our paste and attach another pearl right on top of nose. Just need a little bit more of it. What we do is next use the toothpick or the broken matchstick or broken toothpick and just create some freckles. create some freckles. And the last bit is, what we do is just use a small amount of black writing icing, just to squeeze. And here we are. We finish creating Psycho Delilah here. We just turn a little bit up here. And we're able to have a look a little bit closely on this fun cake. This is great cake to create with children. They really be enjoying decorating by using various sweets. And also, as I said, if you don't find this sort of snacks, you can use any other variety of snacks, long or short. I hope you like this super fun type of cake. Everything will be in the description box. Please do have a look. Thank you very much for your time with me today. Until next time, goodbye.